The question is not about which one is more prominent or which one is highly paid, but rather it is all about the commitment that I had made. Dear friends, welcome to my 18th episode of my world travel stories. And today I'm going to share an interesting experience about my journey to United Arab Emirates. On the 19th of July 2011, I received a phone call from Mr. Samuel asking if I was available on the 3rd of December to speak and perform for 10 minutes at the Christmas program at Inglewood School, which is a kindergarten school located in Bangalore. I looked at my schedule and I told him that I'm available and confirmed the date too. On the 21st of July, I landed in Dubai and performed a series of concerts, and in one such concert, I met Sabu George and the Voice International team. And the next day, that is 26th of July, I got an email from Sabu saying that 2nd of December 2011, United Arab Emirates will be celebrating their 40th National Day. And for the very first time, about 100 churches across all denominations in the UAE were going to gather on Friday the 3rd of December to celebrate and pray over the nation of UAE, and they called it Bless UAE. He also added that His Excellency Abdullah Mohammed Salah, who was then the governor of Dubai International Financial Center, and in fact he was one of the pioneers of banking system of UAE, was confirmed as the chief guest. They had met as a committee and unanimously agreed to have me as the chief artist to perform and share on this very important event, and wanted to know if I was available. I was so excited and blessed to have been chosen. I looked at my schedule and found out that I had already committed to the kindergarten school program on the 3rd of December. I asked Sabu for a couple of days so that I can reply back to him, and so that I can also check with Samuel to see if the dates can be shifted, and I immediately wrote to Samuel. After a couple of days, I got a call from Samuel saying that he checked with the parents and most of them had already applied for leave for the 3rd of December event, and hence changing of the date was not possible. But he did say, "Benny, the UAE event is very big and prominent and our event is small, so please go ahead and say yes to Sabu and we will manage." I told him, "Brother Samuel, the question is not about which one is more prominent or which one is highly paid, but rather it is all about the commitment that I had made." I called up Sabu and mentioned that the event on the 3rd of December at Inglewood School cannot be changed. And since I have given my word to Samuel first, I want to honor that commitment. So the only option, if you want me to be there for the event, is to shift to an earlier or a later date. I told him, "I know it's a big loss of a lifetime opportunity for me, but for me, commitment comes first." Sabu said that they have a committee meeting in the evening and he will update me what the committee decides. On the 9th of October, I got an email from Sabu saying that all of them have agreed to shift the date to the 1st of December. God really blessed me with the opportunity to honor the commitment as well as to be a blessing at Bless UAE. I arrived in Dubai on the 30th of November 2011, and on the 1st of December at 7:30 p.m., the Bless UAE event kicked off at the Sheikh Rashid Auditorium located in the Indian High School. It was a memorable event, and I even got to present my world record travel map of my travels to 245 nations to His Excellency Abdullah Mohammed Salah. He was a gentle soul and we had an amazing chat. And the next day I was invited to his office to have a 30-minute one-on-one chat where he wanted to know more about my testimony. These are some photos of the event. It was indeed a taste of heaven to see so many nationalities and denominations under one roof. The next day I ministered at different church services, and on the 3rd of December I boarded the flight at 3:40 a.m. and arrived in Bangalore at 8:50 a.m. I was able to rest a little bit and went to Inglewood School and performed and shared at the Christmas program in the evening. I'm reminded of two verses from the Holy Bible. 1 John 2 verse 5 says, "But whoever keeps his word, in him truly the love of God is perfected. By this we may know that we are in him." And James chapter 5 verse 15 says, "But above all, my brothers, do not swear either by heaven or by earth or by any other oath, but let your yes be yes and your no be no, so that you may not fall under condemnation." Dear friends, in the world we live, loyalty or commitment has become very subjective. In today's world, money, comfort, safety or fame becomes the basis for our commitment. Look at what the Bible teaches. It's very important for us to keep our commitment, our word. Whether it is to our family members, to our friends, or even to strangers, let your yes be yes and no be no. Think twice before you take an oath or you make a commitment. But once you make it, make sure that you stand by it. Regardless of how much you're going to lose or you're going to gain, let your commitment be number one. And God will bless you. He will honor your words. He will honor the stand that you have taken. For me, it was a challenge. But God really gave me the strength. As a human, I would have easily gotten attracted to fame and the big opportunities that are there. But it is the fear of the Lord that gives me the strength to hold on to the commitments that are there, that I've made, and that has blessed me tremendously. Think twice about that. The world we live in, many times people don't honor these commitments. Look at the corporate life. There's not much of loyalty that is there. It's all about making money. It's all about rising the ladder of success. But commitment and loyalty should go hand in hand. And once we have that as part of our character, I'll tell you, we can depend on each other and we can grow from strength to strength. If you have not subscribed to my YouTube channel, please do go to youtube.com/Benny Prasad, and there's a bell icon there. Please click on it so that every time I post a video, you will be notified. And I would love to receive your comments too. Please do share these videos to your family members and to your friends too. May God bless you all.